So in this video, we'll see how to import the requirements from Microsoft Excel document into our HP ALM. Now the very first question is, why do we need to import? Suppose if you are a manual tester, you're working on the manual testing part, you have written all your requirements into your Excel file. Now if you want to migrate to HP ALM, there should be some plugin, that's the Excel add-in, which should help you to import all the requirements from your Excel file to your HP ALM. So let us see practically. Now what are the steps we'll be following when we are importing the requirements into HP ALM? So these are the particular steps. Very first thing, you should have the credentials, the username, the password. Only then you can log into the HP ALM, the login tab itself. Second one, we'll be doing a field mapping. Whatever fields are present in HP ALM, those should be mapping with the Excel field itself. So there is a process known as field mapping, which you have to work on. And the next time when the field mapping is done, we need to validate the contents, whether the contents are matching with the HP ALM data itself. And the last one, we can just upload all the requirements from Excel file to HP ALM. So let us see practically, how do we import the requirements from Excel file to HP ALM? Now after downloading and installing the Excel add-in, let us see how do we import the requirements from Excel document to our HP ALM. So for that, few things you have to take care about. Now if I just create a new requirement in HP ALM, if I see this option, if I create on this place, I'll get a dialog box. Make sure whatever requirements fields are mandatory, for example the name and the requirement type. If you want to upload a requirement, these two fields are required, that is the name field and the requirement type field. The remaining fields, if you keep it empty or if you don't fill, still it will work. So I'll just click on this. I'll just go to the desktop because I have already a requirement document which I've created in the Excel file. I'll just double click on this place. So I have a Excel file which I have requirement test cases and the defects. Few examples I've given here. Now I'll just explain you what it is exactly. The first row contains the fields of the requirement. I'll just highlight it. So the first row, it will contain all the fields itself, like the name of the requirement, the type of the requirement, priority, author and path. So I'll just make into a border so it is easy to understand, and I'll remove the grid lines. So now if you observe here, this is the requirement name, that's a requirement type. Make sure whatever type of requirement you're using, let's say for example functional, undefined or performance, this requirements type should be in the HP ALM. If you insert invalid requirement type, it will not be accepted. For example, I have 5, 4, 3, 2 or whatever priorities I have. If I try to insert a priority named as 6, very urgent, it will not be accepted. Okay. So all the data, whatever you have in the requirement field, should be validated first and only then you can export it. Okay. So let us see practically how do we do that. Now very first thing is, observe I have total 5 number of records and 1 row heading. 5 number of records and 1 row heading. So first thing is, I'll just go to HP ALM, upload add-in, and then I'll click on this login. So you have to log in with your URL. This is a URL for this HP ALM. Insert your username, insert your password, click on authenticate. Select the domain under which you want to upload the requirement and also the project itself. Then you can click on this login button. Now when you click on this login button, the other fields on the tab would be activated. If you see this domain, the project, these are activated now. Earlier these options were deactivated. They were not, you know, enabled. They were disabled earlier. Now let us see what can be done. The names which are given here, that's a name here, and the type, these fields are not necessary. They would be the same in this place. If you come here like this, if I create a new requirement in ALM, I'm just trying to show you. Here it is given as requirement type. This is given as functional, undefined and performance. But in my Excel document, this is not the requirement type. It is just given as type, if you observe. So what I have to do is, I have to do a mapping of this Excel fields with my HP ALM fields. So what I have to do is, I have to keep my cursor on the first row, first cell. Click on this mapping part and you'll be getting a dialog box. Here it says ALM Excel add-in field mapping. Select the entity type. So either you can upload requirements, defects or test. So I'll select the requirements part. If I select requirements, all the fields in the requirements in the ALM will be visible here. If you observe, these are ALM fields. If I click here, let's say for example defects, so I'll be getting all the fields in ALM which are for the defects. If you select test, you'll be getting fields related to test. Now when you select here test, on the right hand side you see there are three ALM fields which are mandatory. You see subject, test name and type. If you select from here as requirement, it says name is required and the requirement type is required. So these are the fields in ALM. On the right hand side, these are the columns in the Excel file. So there are two methods by which you can do the mapping part. If I just move it on this place, yeah. Now if I just click on this auto map, it will try to correlate the headings from this place into ALM field. I'll just click on auto map. You'll get a dialog box. Let us see what it says. Specify the row number in Excel where the fields label appear. My fields label appear in the first row. So if you observe here, I've entered as first. First row, I'll click on OK. Now, if you carefully observe what happened is, name field in ALM is same as Excel A column. So if you see A column, requirement type, it is filled as blank because requirement type in ALM and here it is known as type. So the name is changing here. Priority is given in the C column, which is absolutely correct. If you open this HP ALM like this one, and if you see there's a priority given, yeah, this one priority. So same is the name of the column in my Excel file. Okay. An author is also given and the path is also given. What is the path given here? Under which folder do you want to paste this requirement? So the path, if you leave empty, it will be stored here. It will be stored under this requirements folder. If you give some path, let's say Mercury Tools, it will be stored under this particular folder itself. So make sure you give the particular path itself, right? Now, after that, since I've selected requirements and I clicked on auto map, I have mapped the fields and now I have to manually type the requirement column number. So requirement type column number is B. Okay, I have to manually do that. So remember, it will not accept the cell number, but it will accept the column number. These are the column numbers, column names which are given, and these are the field names. Now when you click on OK, let's see what happens. When you click on OK, this column or this row is generated, which will say requirement type in ALM is this type in the Excel file itself. So even if you don't have this column, this row, if you don't have, this row will be generated. Okay, it says these are the names of the fields in the ALM part, in the requirements, right? So now what is the next step? The next step is I have to check whether this data, whatever I have, is it valid or not. So how do I check it? I can just simply select this data. Okay, I'll simply select this data here and I'll click on validate. So if I click on validate, it says there are some errors into your data. Check the data mark in red and see the validation comments. I'll click on OK. So this is some error message. Click on OK. What is this error message? It says user do not exist. There is no user named as Rita in your file. So I'll just change it to name as Pavan. Okay. And again, I'll select this data and I'll click on validate. Okay. Now the validation has passed. Why do we need validation? Now, for example, if there is a requirement type as functional, by mistake, if I write as functional 2, which is not exactly in my HP ALM, will this be accepted or not? So let's see, if I select this option, this data, and then if I click on this validate, you see what happened? Only this field has been highlighted with the comments. I'll just click on OK. If I keep my cursor here, it says invalid requirement type. So make sure you correct the requirement type. So I'll make it as this one, and then I can click on this validate. It says the validation has been passed and the comments has been removed here, right? So now observe how many requirements I have. Total, I have 5 requirements. 2 requirements, there is no path, and 3 requirements, it will be stored under this Mercury Tools folder. I'll show you the folder here. This is my Mercury Tools folder, this one, Mercury Tools folder. So let's see now. Select the entire records and then you can click on this upload to ALM. If I click on upload to ALM, it will say processing. The data has been successfully uploaded. I'll click on OK. Now, before jumping to ALM, see what are the requirements. These are 5 requirements. Flights and hotels, this will be below the requirements folder. This 3 will be under this Mercury Tours folder. So I'll jump to this HP ALM. I've exported from Excel, but it is not reflected here. So what with the issue is, you need to just refresh this, or you have to press F5. If you refresh this thing, and if you observe, if I just maximize this, now if you see, the number of requirements are more than what it was earlier, because if you see flights and hotels, these two requirements are stored under this one requirements folder. Okay, under this requirements folder, flights and hotels are stored. I'll just go back. Flights and hotels are stored under requirements folder. If nothing is there, that means requirements folder. The other three are stored under this Mercury tours. So I'll just go back. The other three, and if you see, I'll just expand. This one, car rentals, registration, login performance. These are stored under this Mercury tools. You might think about login and logout, but this requirement we have created previously. In the previous videos, I've shown you how to create these requirements, right? So this is the simplest and the easiest method to export the data from your Excel to your HP ALM add itself. I hope you have understood how to export the data, and that's all for this video.